friend. remarkable, isn't it? This tomb has been hidden for, well, who knows how long. I've had a look around, and the only interesting thing I found
moons.
Is an inscription here and a switch below it. Now, I'm not sure if you can read the dragon language, but this seems to be a riddle of some sort. A sacrifice will bring you closer to that which you seek. I wonder what it means. Mind your step. Lead the way. This is most exciting, wouldn't you agree? direction. Since you seem to know what you're doing, why don't you lead the way?
Khajiit guards your back. I will shoulder some of your burden. We follow then.
Walking in these chambers is like walking in the... Other than that plaque, there doesn't seem to be anything else worthy of note. Let's see what the inscription says. All men must die, often by their own means. Sounds rather grim, if you ask me. The inscription must be a reference to these pillars. Three pillars surrounding a central one. Perhaps they're connected somehow. They also have glowing stones of some kind at the top. They look vaguely similar to drawings I've seen of objects called impact stones. Well, see what you can figure out. I'm going to inspect these pillars further to see if I've missed something. Ah, that's the trick.
Take.
If anyone sneaks up on us, I'll smell them coming. Or I might not. We will see. If anyone sneaks up on us, I will shoulder some of your burden.
Lead on, friend. You are taking us.
I will shoulder some of your burden.
Khajiit will follow.
Translate the inscription. The writing describes a guardian who defeated someone named Mirak. In fact, if I'm reading this correctly, it says that Mirak was a traitor. Most interesting. There's probably an exit through one of these sarcophagi. Let's get moving. Along with them. Continue along the path. Don't tread where you've been. Interesting. Well, only five more to go. Splendid. The gates have opened.
Thank you. Fire!
Another riddle. Stay your course, to idle is to die. Well, at least it's straightforward. There appears to be a switch of some kind here. I'll just stand over here while you flip that switch. I'm sure everything will be fine. By the nine, I've never seen anything like this. I had no doubt you'd make it across. Let's see what awaits us ahead. That looks like quite a drop. Is there something moving down there?
Watch it.
think you were going to survive that fall, let alone those things that were down there. Oh, the Hall of Stories. These are found in many ancient Nord tombs. There must be hundreds of years of history etched in these walls. Too bad they seem too damaged to read. Looks like it needs some sort of key. Maybe those half claws you found would fit in here if you put them together. It's these rings can be moved. Perhaps there's enough undamaged text in these etchings to tell us the combination. Ah, yes. Here's something. The first one has to do with a breeze. Or maybe it's wind. The second one mentions the night sky and the moon. The third is fire. It also seems to mention spirits. That's all I can make out from this etching. I'll check the rest and see if there's anything else. You keep trying out the combination. There you go. I didn't doubt you for a second. Let's see what's on here. I can't wait to get back to the village. Don't like about it. In all my years as a historian, I never thought I'd see anything like that.
I suppose that was Valak. He must have had this entire place built for him so that he could maintain his vigil, even beyond death. Indeed. I knew that the dragon priests were thought to have been powerful men of great will, but I had no idea. Well, I suppose I've seen everything I came for, and you kept up your end of the bargain. I promised payment, and here it is. Now I think I'll spend some more time studying this word war. What a book this will make! You can leave if you like. I think I'll be safe now. A good question. Partly to keep unwanted intruders away, I suppose. They might also have been Mentor's tests to ensure that only the truly worthy can reach the main burial chamber. Who can say, really? The motives of the dragon priests are as inscrutable as those of the dragons they worshipped. This is clearly a tomb, if a rather elaborate one. I would guess it was built for a dragon priest who achieved great fame in his time. It seems he was held in high regard by both men and dragons, because he defeated a traitor named Mirak. Perhaps Mirak was also a dragon priest, probably a contemporary of this guardian. He must have turned against his own order. After his defeat, Mirak was banished to Solstheim, and the guardian was made his jailer. I've been thinking about that, and I believe it does. I believe it was the ancient ancestors of the Skull who built this tomb for their master, the dragon priest they called the Guardian. In all likelihood, these people were ancient Nords who came with the dragon priest to live here on Solstheim. Separated from their people on the mainland, they developed a distinct culture that became the Skull we know today. Of course, this is all just theory and conjecture. It is likely we will never know the truth. Right then.
Yeah!